Again, this cathedral built by the Medici family. This is the main Piazza del Duomo in Pietrasanta. How beautiful can you be?
On top also.
So it's a very old quarry, I suppose, a Renaissance quarry.
This palace was somewhere
right here on the right there?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we have the summer palace for the Medici family right here.
Yeah, look at the.
Oh, I love the pine, the spruce, I guess. Yeah, there's plenty of marble here. Mamma mia! Okay, we go. Unbelievable. Oh, fantastic. Yeah, he'll love that, Nicola. Can you pronounce it violet or violet? Violetta breccia?
Breccia violetta.
Mm-hmm. Very ancient. Now, did this come out of the quarry of the Medici?
The old quarry was by family, Medici's family.
Medici family.
Yeah. And now the quarry is closed, but we can find a little piece of.
Excellent, excellent. Just.
It's very difficult to find.
It looks like a nice piece. It's consistent. I don't see any.
Any cracks. We will see. On the top.
Okay. What we see here is Violet Breccia from the ancient quarry of the Medici family. How many tons do you think, kilograms? Estimate.
I think it's about 6 tons.
6 tons, excellent. A diamond continuous saw, bandsaw basically, that can cut marble, granite, anything you want. You have a block on that trolley right there in front, and it'll rotate back and forth, or rotate around as the diamond cable is cutting it. And you can get just about anything you want out of this machine here. It's a beautiful morning here in Pietrasanta, Italy. I'll pan up to the top of the mountain here and you can see where we are. It's a very old sculpture complex. dating back to the Renaissance. There's many artists that work here and they come from all over the world. I'm just one of many that seek out the marble here in Pietrasanta. So much marble here, you wouldn't believe it. There's enough to build pyramids over and over and over. This is just the yard where leftover pieces have been stored, stacked, ready for something else that may be coming along. All nice white Carrara marble. There's an interesting piece right there that's done by the famous artist Indiana. It's a piece of scrap. It's the famous love sculpture that you see in New York. There's about 90 pieces of this sculpture all over the world. There's some pink marble. We'll pan around. We have pieces ready to be shipped out. This is the main office of the Barsanti Marble Company. They more or less run the complex here. They handle all the mosaics. There's a bronze foundry over in the far corner. We can't see it now, but mainly marble sculpture here. Very extensive work going on all the time. And we're coming back to the Violet Breccia. 8 tons.
Sto lavorando per te, ma ci dovevo spendere un po' qua, questo perché qua.
Is that the Azul?
No, it's a Sodalite. It's not looks, grain.
It looks like the earth.
Yeah, it's not grain.
That's probably the machine that'll turn the columns.
For made the hole.
Uh-huh. You miss your old saw that, it was a good saw, huh? One of these catch-all rooms where everybody just kind of throws their stuff while they're working, but there's endless sculpture, as you can see, everywhere you go. I could walk out back amongst the bamboo, and there's plaster maquettes there that have been there for years and years. The weeds have just grown up around them. Each and every one of these plaster models was the beginning of a monumental piece of sculpture that went someplace in the world. As you can see, there are just hundreds and hundreds of them. This is a piece of sculpture from the maestro Nicola Stagetti. As you can see, it's a brilliant piece of work. I'm not sure where this is going, but amazing thing about working on two pieces, they both have to be good, they both have to be precise, and it's especially challenging to sculpt two faces so close together. Because the tools sometimes are long, and you have to be careful not to hammer the other one while you're working on one subject. So, and this is the most interesting. This is a plaster model of a hand carved by Michelangelo.